when some of the scholars will say والوفاء مع النفس يكون بمحاسبتها. That how do we become fulfilling our duties toward our own nafs? How? That we account ourselves. We sit down each and every day and you account yourself. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. That all who believe, يعني, sit down with you, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let each and every person look at his nafs, look at his soul and count it, and make sure that we sit ourselves an hour each and every day, that we always say, what did I do? What I have, what I have accomplished, what I have done to myself. And if we don't do that, something is wrong, my dear brothers and sisters, because this is extremely important. In each and every organization, in each and every hospital, in each and every business, there have to be an hour of accounting yourself. Otherwise, you're not going to be a successful person. You're not going to be a successful engineer. You're not going to be a successful doctor unless you accept and you account yourself. And to be a successful Muslim, you have to sit down and account yourself, my dear brothers and sisters. The third kind of wafa is that you become wafa with the people. And there are many people that we have different duties toward us. And the most important people that we have duties toward them is our parents. يعني أنبر والله العظيم, this is the most important type of wafa. A person who have brought you, who have spent money on you, the one who have carried you for 9 months, and after all of that you forget, like nothing have happened. What is the wafa in here? What is the wafa? When you wish that you're fulfilling the promises and fulfilling your duty toward them. Your own wife. What is the one who take care of your own children? The one that mops the floor possibly and make the dishes and cook for you and take care of you, and you come home and everything is clean. And then the least thing that you could do is yell at her and mistreat her and be down related to her. Is that part of wafa, fulfilling the promise? Vice versa. How is the wife should be also fulfilling her duty toward her husband? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَإِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَةُ خَمْسَهَا وَصَامَتْ شَهْرَهَا وَحَفِظَتْ فَرْجَهَا وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا أَدْخَلَهَا الْجَنَّةِ مِنْ أَيِّ أَبْوَابِهَا. That a woman, if she did few things, in which that she prayed her five, and she fasted her month, and she protected her private parts, and she obeyed her husband, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make her into any of the doors of the Jannah. Nowadays, unfortunately, it's like almost a taboo when we talk about how a woman supposed to be, obeying her husband. But this is reality. Just like, you know, you have duty toward her, she have duty toward you.